रेडी स्टार्ट। दी अपीलांट इज एग्रीव्ड बाय अ जजमेंट ऑफ द मध्य प्रदेश हाई कोर्ट विच कन्फर्म्ड हिज कन्विक्शन फॉर द ऑफेंस पनिशबल अंडर सेक्शन 302 ऑफ द इंडियन पीनल कोड कॉमा एंड द सेंटेंस ऑफ रिग्रेस इम्प्रिजनमेंट फॉर लाइफ इम्पोज्ड ऑन हिम फुल स्टॉप पैरा। द फैक्ट्स आर दैट पुलिस स्टेशन जबेरा received information in the evening of 9/3/1992 that a truck had broken the forest department barrier and collided with a motorcycle full stop. The receipt of this information alerted the police full stop. It was further alleged that sub-inspector D.K. Tiwari along with others were stationed at a vantage point on the main road when the truck reached their full stop. S.I. Tiwari motioned the truck to stop. It was driven by the appellant full stop. Instead of applying brakes, the accused tried to speed away, upon which S.I. Tiwari boarded the truck from its left side full stop. Para. At that stage, it is alleged that the accused appellant warned S.I. Tiwari not to do so and that he would get killed full stop. Nevertheless, S.I. Tiwari boarded the truck full stop. Immediately, the appellant pushed him, as a result of which S.I. Tiwari fell off the truck and he was run over the rear wheels of the truck full stop. S.I. Tiwari died full stop. It is further alleged that the appellant fled with the truck full stop. He was later caught, arrested and charged with committing murder of S.I. Tiwari full stop para. In the trial before the additional session judge Damoh, the prosecution relied upon the depositions of 18 witnesses, besides several exhibits, including the postmortem report, seizure of articles from the site, and the deposition of medical witness PW6, the prosecution essentially relied upon the statements of PW2, PW10, PW11, PW14, and PW15. That is the principal eyewitness full stop. The accused also led oral evidence of 3 witnesses, including that of Majid PW1, who deposed that he was the conductor who was in the truck when the incident had occurred full stop para. After duty considering the entire evidence, the materials led before it, the trial court, by its judgment and order, convicted the appellant as charged and sentenced him to rigorous imprisonment for life full stop. The appeal against the conviction and sentence was rejected by the impugned order full stop para. It was argued on behalf of the appellant by Ms. Ritu Nagar, advocate, that a close reading of the evidence disclosed that the depositions of PW2, PW10, PW14 and PW15 contain fatal contradictions and exaggerations full stop. It was pointed out that the prosecution version about the deceased bordering the truck from its left side and being pushed by the appellant was highly improbable, given that 2 witnesses had clearly deposed that the latter, that is the accused, continued to drive the truck full stop. It was submitted that if such was the position, unless the prosecution established that the deceased had actually boarded the truck and sat in it near the driver, it was impossible for the accused to have pushed him with such force that he would have fallen off and gotten crushed under the rear wheels. Feeling aggrieved and dissatisfied with the impugned judgment and order dated 5/9/2019, passed by the High Court of Judicature for Rajasthan Bench at Jaipur in BD Special Appeal Writ Number 560 of 2019 as well as the order dated 5/12/2019 passed in DB Review Petition Number 250 of 2019, by which the Division Bench of the High Court had dismissed the said appeal and has confirmed the judgment and order passed by the learned single judge dated 23/1/2019, by which the learned single judge allowed the said writ petition preferred by the respondent herein and quashed and set aside the order of terminating the services of the respondent employee herein, original writ petitioner, on the ground of supersession of material facts of conviction and penalty at that time, of applying for the post in 2013 and also submitting a false declaration at the time of documents verification on 14/4/2015. The employer Rajasthan Raj Vidyut Prashasan Nigam Limited and another have preferred the present appeal, full stop para, that the appellants herein invited applications for the post of technical helper by issuing advertisement in the month of October 2013, full stop. Pursuant to the said advertisement, respondent herein employee applied for the said post, full stop. The written test was held on 2/2/2014 and result of which was declared on 31/3/2015, full stop. The date fixed for the documents verification was 14/4/2015, full stop. The respondent herein, having qualified for the said post, was appointed as a technical helper as probationer trainee for a period of 2 years on 6/5/2015 and was placed under superintending engineer Jodhpur, full stop para, as per condition number 16 of the terms and conditions of the appointment order. The appointment of the respondent was subject to production of a character certification verification report issued by the superintendent of police of the concerned district where the belongs, full stop. The superintendent of police Sawai Madhopur wide police verification antecedents report dated 5/6/2015 informed the appellants that a case bearing number 13 of 2011 against the respondent employee for the offences under sections 143, 341, 323 IPC in which a charge sheet was filed against the respondent employee on 17/1/2011 and the learned trial court convicted the respondent's employee void judgment and order dated 5/8/2013 convicting him for the offences under sections 341 and 323 IPC. However, given the benefit under the Probation of Offenders Act 1958, full stop para, while giving the benefit of Act 1958, the respondent employee was ordered to be released on probation for good conduct, full stop. It is to be noted that even subsequently such conviction of the respondent employee came to be confirmed, however, the learned sessions judge void judgment dated 9/9/2015 granted the benefit of section 12 of the Act 1958 to the respondent employee, which provides that a person shall not suffer disqualification attaching to the conviction, full stop para, having found that the respondent employee deliberately suppressed the fact of conviction and penalty not only at the time of applying for the post, but also on 14/4/2015.